My name's James Bentley, I'm a director of Paradigm Developments from York. Paradigm Developments, we've been established for around 12 years. We're based in the York area, but we do work all over the country. And we specialise in doing jobs that other people don't really ever want to do. So we work on listed buildings, awkward buildings, renovations, refurbs, new builds, everything really. From a light bulb to a full refurb. Like a turnkey solution, you know.
How did you come across the Aquapol system?
I went along to the listed building show and I'd wander around and came across your colleagues. I wasn't sure what these beehive things were that were hanging from the ceiling, so I asked what these things were. It turned out that's what they did. They were a damp remedial system. And so I brought some catalogues away from the show, gave them to our client. They contacted you direct, and that's where we've gone from up till today.
What were your first thoughts when you saw the system?
First thoughts when I saw them, I thought the brochure looked very good, some very nice European buildings on there. The Parliament building in Budapest, I think, is on the back of there, one of your jobs. So I thought, you know, it looks good. Not too sure if I understand the science behind it, but it obviously works. So, like I said, this was a really tricky property to alleviate the damp issues. So this is why I gave the client the brochure, and he obviously thought it was a good idea. But at first, everyone I've spoken to are very sceptical. Didn't understand it, didn't understand how this beehive-shaped thing could actually do any good. which I imagine that's what most people say.
Did you notice yourself any changes during this past 5 months?
The only thing we did notice, we put datum lines around the walls in sort of a chalk or a pen, I can't remember what they were. And these datum lines, after the installation, started to run down the wall as if the damp in the wall, where the datum line was on, was going down. So that's the only thing we've really noticed. Other than the walls seem to be pretty dry, you know, when we're drilling into them. And we've done everything we can as a builder to alleviate the problems. And where we've built new walls, everything's obviously got damp-proof membranes in. But just for the external, well, and the internal walls, everything that goes down through onto the foundations, not this building has foundations, it's so old, it's just on huge pieces of stuff. So we've done everything we can, and there wasn't really a lot else we could do. Trying to inject these walls would have been a disaster because there's no courses to the stonework, huge cavities and pockets everywhere, and obviously no original damp membrane at all. But other than that, anything we've noticed? No, just the lack of damp now, really.
Did you ask for a quotation regarding the chemical side? Didn't even go there.
I didn't even really bother with a price of the chemical. I mean, we could have done, you know, the plastic that you put on the walls, wrapping around. We fitted that before, like a tanking system. It's very laborious. It takes ages to fit. You can't pierce it at all. You know, if you wanted to hang something on this wall, as soon as you pierce that membrane, then you've got an issue. So from a practicality point of view, from a usability point of view, those systems aren't particularly brilliant. And they take a long time to fit, and they're very expensive. So we never even got a quote for anything chemical-wise.
Mm-hmm. If you would went down on a tanking system, the same you described earlier, do you have just a rough idea in terms of price, what would have cost for a cottage of this size?
I have no qualms that it would have been £10,000-£15,000, I thought, for the kit. And then we've got to install it. So it's quite pricey thing to do. We could have gone down sand and cement route, you know, sand and cement rendering. But again, it's a lot of work, it's a lot of material to put on by hand, so again, very labour intensive. And again, if you pierce it with sockets, you know, cutting out for round sockets and things, then you have issues around those areas where damp can come back.
Thank you very much.